The cosmos is huge, which is why we continue to find new things. It implies that humanity has researched the solar system in great detail. The planets have all been discovered for a long time, rovers have been wandering on Mars for a while, meteors and asteroids have basically all been named, and even the soil from one of them has been removed and transported to Earth for investigation. The scientists, however, were flabbergasted at this point. It turns out that our entire solar system is surrounded in a gigantic bubble. But what is this gigantic bubble? And do we actually live in this massive bubble? Keep on watching to find out more. So, what is this gigantic bubble? According to recent research, Earth is surrounded by a gigantic bubble roughly 1,000 light-years across, the borders of which control the development of all surrounding young stars. Astronomers have known for decades that the solar system is located within the local bubble, which is the name of this massive bubble, a massive emptiness surrounded by hundreds of newborn stars. However, there is still a lot of mystery surrounding this bubble, from its specific size and structure to its origins and growth. Researchers looked into this bubble in a new study and discovered some surprising new information about how it influences star formation. Researchers have investigated a set of events that began 14 million years ago and resulted in a still-expanding cosmic bubble enveloping Earth's galactic neighborhood, producing all of the nearest stars, for the first time, according to a release. All stars and star-forming areas within 500 light-years of Earth are on the surface of the local bubble, but not within, providing insights as to why Earth is located in a fairly empty section of the Milky Way galaxy. Surprisingly, research lead author Catherine Zucker, an astronomer at the Space Telescope Science Institute, revealed that all nearby star-forming regions lay exactly on the local bubble's surface. Catherine also said, "We stumbled upon this discovery completely by chance. The local bubble was generated by a succession of supernovae, or enormous explosions that occur when stars collapse at the end of their lives. Over the last 14 million years, explosions at the void center have shot gas beyond space." According to Zucker, the shockwave collected clouds of gas and dust into a thick, freezing, hollow shell that formed the surface of the local bubble. On the bubble's surface, the clouds of gas and dust supplied enough fuel for star-forming areas. The density of space rises as you move away from the sun. Although space is commonly thought to be a vacuum, this is not totally accurate. Even if matter has a very low density, it nevertheless exists. The solar wind does have an average density of protons and electrons of 3 to 10 particles per cubic centimeter in the solar system, although it decreases as one gets further away from the sun. The solar system's edge has the lowest density of space. The heliopause is the name for this barrier. On it, the solar wind, the flow of charged particles generated by the sun, or solar plasma, slows to a standstill. The heliosphere is the space between the sun and the heliopause. This is a bubble in which all of the planets of the solar system are contained. Researchers wanted to make a map of the important features in the galactic environment of the solar system. Within 650 light-years of the sun, they studied the 3D locations, forms, and movements of heavy gases and newborn stars. One of the most challenging aspects of the research was the sheer number of dimensions needed to build a real 3D physical picture of star formation on the bubble's surface, Zucker said. "Making a map like this is a huge amount of work and it is complicated." Zucker said, "The research involved mapping three dimensions of space, three dimensions of motion and a time dimension. Now we can literally turn back the clock and see how these star-forming regions evolved over the past millennia." In contrast, most of our traditional understanding of stellar birth has been based on static 2D images of star-forming regions. The scientists were able to recreate the chain of events that led to the formation and expansion of the local bubble by analyzing the movements of these young stars. They determined that these stars were mostly heading straight away from the bubble's surface, implying that they were moving according to the bubble's expansion. One of the findings of this study was that around 14 million years ago, a sequence of around 15 devastating star explosions known as supernovae began to occur in the local bubble's core. Zucker explained that the supernova explosions unleashed a shock wave, which swept up a layer of dense, cold gas which is the local bubble's surface which has now imploded to form hundreds of new stars. Supernovae had long been suspected to sweep up gas into thick clouds that eventually create new stars, but the researchers of this study were shocked to discover that nearly every new star near the sun is developing on the surface of the local bubble. "We can now explain how all local star formation began, providing extremely strong evidence for the long-held concept of supernova-driven star formation, in which stellar death may prompt stellar birth," according to this discovery. Since the first supernova exploded around 14 million years ago, a supernova related to the bubble has exploded about every million years, according to the latest findings. Zucker added to the research, "We think we know which clusters were responsible for the supernovae that powered the expansion of the bubble. These two clusters, called Upper Centaurus Lupus and Lower Centaurus Crux in the famous SCO Ken Stellar Association, formed very close to each other 15 million to 16 million years ago, so all the stars in these two clusters have approximately the same age." A fun fact to be aware of is that the stars in these two clusters had a variety of masses when they were born. The stars that were huge enough to explode as supernovas also had the shortest lives. The bubble was traveling at around 60 miles per second when it originally formed. The bubble is still expanding at a rate of 4 miles per second. According to Gaia. Gaia is a European satellite agency space telescope that uses the finest precision of any project to map the locations of over 1 billion stars. Gaia can assist us in learning more about the Milky Way's origins and development by constructing a 3D map of 1 billion stars. We're talking about a huge bubble here. But do we actually live in this massive bubble? Because the solar system is far older than 14 million years, astronomers believe it is in the midst of the bubble. That means we're right in the middle of it. The Sun was far away from the local bubble when the initial supernovae that formed it exploded, according to João Alves, an astronomer at the University of Vienna. The Sun entered the local bubble around 5 million years ago, and it now lies towards the center. The fact that the Sun is now located in the center of the local bubble implies that similar superbubbles may exist across the Milky Way. Otherwise, what are the chances that our Sun is right in the middle of one? Zucker said. To get a better picture of it, imagine that the Milky Way may be compared to Swiss cheese, with holes blasted out by supernovae and new stars growing in the cheese surrounding the holes left by dead stars. Zucker also explained that they hope to map out more bubbles and their relationships with each other in future study, because the local bubble may be interacting with other bubbles in the galactic neighborhood. One of the most difficult elements will be determining the ages of these bubbles as we travel farther and further away from the Sun, as well as the parent star clusters that will go supernova. However, fresh data from the Gaia project, Gaia DR3, will be invaluable in putting together this puzzle, as it will offer 3D space movements for 30 million stars. So, the heliosphere is as much a part of our cosmic environment as anything else, and knowing how it interacts with the solar wind might be crucial to figuring out the formula for life in the Milky Way and beyond. We can sit and watch the stars form all around us within the mega bubble of our cosmic neighborhood since the Sun and our whole solar system are at the center of our local bubble. What are your thoughts on the local bubble? And do you think we are living in a giant bubble? Let us know in the comments.